Welcome back, friends. In this video, I'll be telling you how to guess questions more accurately for any MCQ exams. Majorly, I'll be talking about for Group C questions in Group C, CSIR, UGC, NET. So you can use this for any kind of exams, any kind of competitive exams with MCQ questions. How to guess a question correctly. Now, first question, why would you have to guess a question? Because there's a negative marking, right? So why would I guess a question if there is negative marking? The answer is simple. It's always a better idea to answer questions confidently. If you can answer the questions confidently and get the qualifying marks easily, that is the best preparation and best choice ever. If you can do that, you don't need to even think about guessing a question. That's the first thing. But second thing, most of the cases what happens is that we are not prepared very well through all of the topics. So what happens in those competitive exams? In most of the students, they answer some questions confidently, but rest of those question marks are not enough for giving them the qualifying exam or giving them the qualification for that particular exam. So to minimize that, in some cases we need to guess some questions. We need to have a guessing so that we increase the marks to get qualified for that exam. But this guessing have both positive as well as negative side. Actually, it has more negative side than positive, because sometimes some people get answer some questions positively, confidently. Say in CSIR NET exam, that person is doing that and all the marks that he answered confidently is giving him 80 out of 200. But we know 80 is not sufficient to qualify CSIR NET GRF. So that person thought that this is the time to guess, because obviously you should only guess if nothing works at all. You should only guess if you try to say and answer the questions confidently, and cumulative marks after even answering things completely and confidently is not enough to give you the scholarship. That's the time to guess. So once you decide that yes, now this is the time to guess, I cannot answer those questions very clearly, I will not be able to qualify based on the marks that I have in confident questions, then only you guess. So once you're guessing, then what happens sometimes, though you get say 80 marks, sometimes guessing give you more negative markings. So you may end up with 50 after 30 number of negative markings. But it's fine to take the risk, because once you know that you cannot answer any perfect questions, any questions confidently enough anymore, getting 80 or getting 50 will not matter at all, because in both the case you are not qualifying, right? If you are getting more than 120, more than 110 the qualified marks, then only you consider it as qualified. So don't think about that this is, I'm going to get 80, if I guess I may end up with getting 20 less or 40 marks less. That doesn't matter at all, because if you are 80 or if you are 50, 60, 100, you are still not be able to get CSIR NET GRF. So what you will do instead, you should check your marks. Once you know that you have to guess, that is the scenario, then you should start guessing the questions. And to how to guess a question, because you know, as I've told you, if you don't know how to guess a question properly, you might end up with more negative markings. So to minimize that, what you can do is that the best way to guess questions is that obviously in a question you have four different options in MCQ. That means to answer a question you have 25% chance for each of those options, right? They have 25% chance to be correct. So what you should do at this point is that instead of picking the right questions, right answer, right options, what you should do is that you can exclude, you start excluding other answers which are non-related. You should exclude all the options which you don't think should be correct, and they will only left up with the correct one. That is the idea, guys, right? So what will you do? In most of the questions, in my experience also, I see most of the times you have a tie between two questions. You may exclude two questions kind of very easily, but you often have tie between two options. So in those two options, you need to choose one, because you have a 50-50 chance of guessing. In those conditions, how to guess it properly? You know, when you're looking at a question, you know the scenario very well, but you are failing to apply the knowledge properly. Or you may know the knowledge, but you don't remember some important, say, name of a protein. If you know the name, you can answer the question correctly and confidently. due to not knowing the name, that might create some problem. So in those situations, what you should do is that you take up each of those options, look after each of those options, think of the options, and think of which option is not related. Exclude that. Do not try to find the correct one directly. Try to find the non-correct one, incorrect one. Discard that. By this way, start discarding other options. And once you start discarding other options which you don't think is going to be correct, the only option you left with should be the correct option most of the time. This is, though it sounds simple, and you may thought, this, what is that word? But believe me, this actually works. You, instead of picking up the right questions always, if you exclude the options which are not true, you end up with the true one. It's most of the 70% of the time it occurs. And another thing you can do is that you sometimes have tie between two options, and you sometimes think in your mind that might be option one is correct, and then after some time you thought, no, option B is correct. First you say A, then B. Now if you have doubt like this and not completely sure, you have the two things and both of them are of same equivalent, in those condition, this is from the perspective of psychology. Most of the cases, in those scenarios, the option you thought earlier, the first time, usually are correct. So no scientific basis. This is a kind of psychological study. I can't say no scientific basis, but actually there are some basis. There are some psychological events and study of these events throughout. And the result came like that. Most of the cases, if you do the guessing and stuff, that option A might correct, then you think no, option B is correct. In those cases, the guess that you make at the first attempt usually are correct. And this is true for 70 or 80% of the time. So you see, these are the stuff that you can do, you can think about, right, to answer the question, right? That's how you should guess a question properly. And if you guess that question properly, you might end up with less negative marking. But remember, guessing is the last option. So if you don't have any other options and you have to only, then only try guessing. Otherwise, you should not, right? So that's it, guys. That's about how you guess a question and also how to minimize the marks. So there are plenty of other advices you can check in my YouTube channel. And to get more and more tips and tricks videos like that, you should subscribe to my channel right now. And hit the like button, share this video with your friends so they also get some benefit from this. Thank you.